Good afternoon.
Good
afternoon. Nice to see you, all of you. Today's title is The Lord Who is the Redeemer. If we read in the verse 22, it says, I have swept away your offense like a cloud, your sins like the morning mist. With a knowing, there is something that has been imprinted in us continually. I was talking about that last week a little bit. Before we met the gospel, this problem of Genesis 3, 6, and 11, it's been imprinted in me. So all human beings, or all of us, without knowing, we are really focused just in myself. Or we are ourself-centered. Our life is going in this way continually. With escape from this Genesis 3, 6, and 11, it is really difficult to have also a relationship with people. There's people who are really kind, and you can make many friends, but there's one moment that always you start to fight, or there's a moment that you guys start to crash each other. If I'm not able to escape from this Genesis 3, 6, and 11, my whole life will be just myself, self-centered. So, if you don't receive answer to solution to this problem, it's going to be really difficult for you to have this kind of a relationship with other people. Why? It could be really hard for you to think about others, but you will be thinking continually in you, yourself. Without knowing this gospel, or without an answer inside of this, these problems start to come to me. It's what I start to listen, what I start to see, what I start to read, right? Or when we watch a movie, these kind of things start to influence a lot in our lives. These days I'm reading a few things on Facebook, and my cousin is uploading some things about philosophy and about other things. And, you know, I've been here for 7 years, so it means from the last 7 years, I couldn't talk that much with my cousin, right? So he's now 20 years old. So 7 years ago, it means he was 13, right? So when I left, he was really young. But now he's already 20, right? The way he think, the way that he wrote all the letters and outlet on Facebook, it made me think a lot, because that kid that I was thinking about, he was 13, really cute, and he was really nice, but I can see the direction that his thinking is going on to now. The way that he think, his own ideology that it came to him, doesn't matter with the gospel. So I realized he was so sweet and cute, but how he become like this? I'm not saying like he's about people or something like that, but I can see how his ideology is completely turning to one point that I don't really like because it's inside of this. So it's my cousin, but how he become this kind of people, this kind of person? Without knowing, or because he didn't listen to the gospel, he was listening about other things, seeing other things, reading about other things, watching on the news other things, and he wasn't able to find an answer to all of that. That is the gospel of Jesus Christ. In other words, if we don't keep understanding the gospel, if we don't keep listening to the gospel of Jesus Christ, our lives will be running inside of this. Why? Because this is the world. Not only this, but we can see that there is six destinies that they bring you destruction to the human beings. Is their spiritual state that they fall into. It's a spiritual state of suffering or destruction in their lives. Remember these things, Jacob, for you, Israel, are my servant, is saying today, right? I have made you, you are my servant, Israel. I will not forget you. I have swept away your offense like a cloud, your sins like the morning mist. Return to me, for I have redeemed you. It's really important words what the Bible is saying to us today. This is the situation of my life. This is the situation of the people in the field. This is our family's life inside of all of this. If you understand this, you will know how important is the Word of God. If you understand this, you will know how important is the fact that you are here worshiping. You will understand how important is worship for you, how important is the preaching of the Word of God, how important is to hold on to the covenant of God. Why? In other words, if everyone is inside here, the only way, or because everyone is inside here, God say, return to me. Amen? Because there is no other answer. God gives us the answer, that is Jesus Christ. So return to me. What does it mean? It means concentration. Because you are a child of God, it means God already is in you, right? It's in your heart. Because you are a child of God. And you are in Him also. You already have salvation. We have this kind of assurance. But what it means then, return to me. If already He's in me, what it means is, it means concentrate on me. Why? There is a reason. If He's not, if you don't do that, it's myself centered, my life. So in consequence, it's really difficult to have relationship with other people. It's really, in really easy way, I will focus just only me, only my success, only my money, my benefits, and that's the thing that will continually destroy me. Of course, will not give you the happiness. Because you are safe, He promised to be with you forever. So what it means, return to me. If a big problem comes to you, how are you going to solve the problem? You are a child of God. God is with you, but you are facing big situation or problem, or a big problem. How are you going to solve that problem? What can we do? This is the reason why God told us to return to me. Because inside of Him, there is a secret. This secret is Christ. What do you mean, return to me? Return to Christ. Hold on to Christ. Why? Christ is the only one who came to destroy this. Why? Because Christ is the only one who is the answer to all our problems. Amen? Because He's the one who can finish what you cannot finish by yourself. That's why, return to me. That's why Bible is telling us today. You may think your problem is different. No, but it's not about religion, Pastor. Doesn't matter with faith. My problem is this. I just need this. I just need this money. I just need a new work. It's not about religion. It's not about faith. It's my mother problem. Or it's my father problem. You may think your problem is even bigger. But actually, it's only three things. It's the original sin. It's the original problem. That's the only problem that the human being has. Because Christ is the answer to all our problems. Only Christ can finish what you cannot finish. That's why Christ is the answer. That's why return to me. Why? Because He's the true... What?
King.
Okay, I will put king first. He's the true king. What else? He's the true prophet who opened the way, right? To meet God. And he's the true priest. Okay. He's the true priest. He's the true and only one way to meet God. He's the true and only one king who can destroy Satan's forces, who can finish with all the curses of the family line. He's the true and only one who died on the cross and finished with all your sins from the past, present, and future. I have swept away your offense like a cloud. There is someone who asked me one day, Pastor, I don't feel comfortable when we do the Lord's Prayer. I said, why? It is because in the Lord's Prayer we say, forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. You say that. But Pastor, I cannot forget really easy the people. She was saying me like this. So every time that I do the Lord's Prayer, I don't feel good. Because my personality is too strong. So when someone does something bad to me, I cannot forgive them. But in the Lord's Prayer, it says, forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. So it means if I don't forgive them, Christ is not going to forgive me. Someone was asking me like this. I don't feel comfortable doing this. Why I cannot forgive others? You are misunderstanding this, I told her. I have swept away your offense. Already he finished all that offense. But still you cannot forgive others. Why? Still, this Christ is not your Christ. Still, you are not deeply rooted enough here. Really, if you are deep inside of the covenant of Christ, doesn't matter how big is the problem, you will have victory. I will talk a little bit more about this later. Look at what in Matthew 16, Peter confessed. He was confessing this. Jesus was asking, who the people say I am? Who the people say I am? You are like one prophet, right? You are like Jeremiah. You are like Isaiah. You are like John the Baptist, or one of the prophets. Everyone there, they knew that he is Jesus. They knew that. They knew that that guy who is doing miracles, that guy who is feeding 5,000 people with bread and fish, everyone knew that his name was Jesus. But why they didn't know? That he is the Christ. The one who must came to save us. Everyone knew Jesus, but Simon Peter confessed, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Peter knew that. What it means? Peter knew that you, Jesus, you are not a simple prophet. You are the true king who came to finish what Satan is doing, Satan's work. You are the true prophet that by believing you, I can receive the true life. You are the true priest who already finished all my curses and the background of hell in my life. You are the Christ. That Christ who must come to redeem me. That Christ who came to finish with all my problems. That by believing you, I will have the righteousness to become child of God. You are that Christ. In that moment, Jesus said, you are blessed. Amen? You meet many people know Jesus. They believe in Jesus. But they don't know this Christ as an answer to their personal life. As much you are receiving an answer inside of this, you will be escaped from this. I bless all of you to be blessed like Simon Peter, to confess wherever you go that Jesus is the Christ. It's not just simple Jesus, it's the Christ. Why return to me? Because only he is the one, the only Jesus. and because no one can help you in this world. What it means, if you have a big problem, how are you going to solve that? If you don't have this secret, it's gonna be impossible. And this secret, you cannot learn in the world. Because the world doesn't have it. With this secret, doesn't matter how big is the problem, if you have the covenant of Christ, you will be able to understand God's time schedule and God's plan for your life. Doesn't matter how big is the problem, if already you have the answer, then it will not become a problem, right? Doesn't matter, because that problem, you will see that not as a problem, but as a way that how God is leading you. You will see that as a time, God's time schedule. I'm trying to do this, but something is happening. It looks like a problem, but it's not a problem. It's God telling you to don't do that. It's time schedule. Really simple, because you are a child of God, and if you have the secret of Christ in your life, God will lead you continually into success, victory. So then, don't be deceived by the situation. Don't be deceived for the difficulties. Just look the opposite. What does this mean? I'm not going as a slave to Egypt. God is sending me to Egypt. This is looking the opposite. Don't be deceived by Satan through the situation. Don't be deceived by Satan through the hardships that you are facing or the problem that you are facing. Go back to Christ and look the opposite. Think in the opposite way. Just go inside of the secret. How can we do that? We give the application. There is one method that God gives us, is the meditation. I didn't know, but I was meeting Pastor Morris in Seoul, and he was telling a lot about this. So I was really blessed about this meeting. Because when we think in meditation, we think like just close our eyes and just meditate in nothing, right? Even if you go yoga or this kind of energy movement or other kind of things, they told you to just put your mind empty, right? They call that meditation. But he was looking the meaning of meditation. And actually, it's not about that, but it's to read the Bible. Meditating the Bible is read the Bible a little bit loudly by yourself. That's meditation. So you can hear it. Your own voice of the Word of God. Our pastor was talking about this, and the place where you can be focused on God. Try to prepare this in your daily day. A place that where you go, always it makes you think about the Word of God. If it's in your table, or in one place in your house. How can I start to enjoy the secret of Christ? These five prayers that we are used to talk these days. Most of believers pray for blessings. God, I have this problem, bless me in this way. Or God, I need this, just give me this. Many of the believers, they just have this kind of prayer. But this is a prayer of Genesis 3, actually. It's not a prayer for the sake of the gospel. It's not a prayer for God's will. It's a prayer for the sake of myself. God, I need this, just give me this. God, I'm your child, bless me in this way. Because I want to do this, open the doors. This is the kind of prayer that we do. Doesn't matter with God's desire. Doesn't matter with God's heart. It's just all about myself. This is the prayer of Genesis 3. We must start to change this kind of prayer. I just need Christ. Inside here, there is everything. You must have this answer. That inside of this secret, there is everything in my life. I don't need nothing else. This is the answer that God gave to me, gave to us. So I know why people fight each other. I know why people they cannot be close with other people. Why? It's all about myself. This is the prayer that they are doing. This is the reason why they get angry with others. Why? Because it's not according I'm thinking. It's not according people are talking to me. In other words, they are forgetting about this Thanksgiving. Start to do this kind of Thanksgiving. From where Christ sent me free. It's the Thanksgiving of salvation. So if you don't restore this, you will not see also this flow of the message. What it means, if you don't restore this Thanksgiving in your prayer, if you don't start to give thanks to the Lord in your prayer will turn completely to Genesis 3. To give me and bless me and this way. So if you are enrolling your life or yourself in this kind of prayer, you will not be able to see this flow of the message. What it means, you will not pray with the message of God. We must pray with the message. Today our pastor gave us the message, we must pray with that. Because that's God's guidance and that's the place where God wants to lead you. So if you don't restore these thanksgivings because salvation, or just because the answer that God is giving to you, if you don't give thanks because this, you will not be able to see the next step in your life. You will not see the flow of the message. What is the flow of the message, or the flow of the Word of God? It's two things. First, you must see this flow of the Gospel. What it means, talking about this. Really, this message is the answer to my country? Is really this message the answer to my family line? Or to my other students or classmates? You must start to see this. Then, the prayer on the flow of the message is also the prayer who hold onto the Word of God and pray with that. It's applying the Word of God. So this moment, something will start to happen. If you restore this Thanksgiving and start to pray for the covenant of God, for the message of God, you will see that you will start to be concentrated or have this concentration into God. And that will be revealed to you as a power. What you will start to feel, if you just pray a little bit with the covenant, greatest strength will come to you. If you just pray a little bit with the promise that God is giving to you, you will start to receive a lot of power. Just receiving this, even you are in your room alone by yourself, if you are able to experience this, if you are able to say, it is right, doesn't matter the situation, God promised to this. Doesn't matter how difficult it could be, if you meditate a little bit in the Word of God and are able to receive this kind of strength, even you are alone in your bed or here in Korea, you will start to see or receive this kind of healing. What it means is healing of your spiritual state. So as a conclusion, you will have this hope for the future. You will see something, a way for your life for the future. How the word is getting fulfilled, you will see that. How the word is getting fulfilled in your life. As the last thing, how can I start to enjoy this? How can I start to experience that really the Lord is the one who delivered. When you have to choose, just choose the gospel. If you are able to choose the gospel, you will start to see how God is fulfilling the word of God. Don't do it by your own thinking, but choose this gospel. Just a challenge choosing the gospel in there. I really pray all of you and for all of you and bless you to start to enjoy this kind of blessings. Let's pray. Dear God, I thank you for your grace. Lord, who is the Redeemer, you give us out this word. Thank you for the secret of Jesus Christ. Let us hold only unto Jesus Christ as a solution to all our problems. And enjoying these five prayers, the secret of prayer, let us have a greatest relationship with you. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen.